Hello friends, welcome to today's topic under GST, that is Input Tax Credit, which is more popularly known as ITC. Input Tax Credit or ITC in relation to a registered person means the GST on purchases or acquisition of goods or services or capital goods by such registered person. It also includes IGST charged on import of goods. It also includes GST payable on reverse charge mechanism. It is important to note in this context that it does not include the tax paid on composition scheme or alternative composition scheme. Let's try to understand the basic eligibility criteria for taking this input tax credit. Input tax credit is available only to a registered person who is registered under GST. Moreover, it is available in respect of input supplies of goods or services which are used or intended to be used in the course or furtherance of business of a person who wants to claim the benefit of ITC. In short, ITC is not available for non-business purpose. It cannot be claimed for non-business purpose. To avail the benefit of input tax credit, it should be credited in the electronic credit ledger. Let's go through other conditions which makes a registered person entitled for this ITC. He should be in possession of a tax invoice or debit note. He should have actually received such goods or service against which he is claiming the ITC. Let's move on to understand as to what are the documentary requirements of by the registered person in order to avail ITC. First and the foremost is an invoice issued by the supplier of goods or service, or the debit note issued by the supplier, and an invoice issued when the tax is payable by the registered dealer and a reverse charge mechanism. Bill of entry as a documentary evidence in case of IGST of imports, and an invoice in case of input service distributor. Let's move on to another important aspect, that is restrictions imposed. To understand the implication of certain restriction imposed as per Rule 36.4, to understand the implication of Rule 36.4, one has to understand the mechanism of Form GSTR-1, filing of Form GSTR-1, and the reflection of this data in GSTR-2A of the recipient. Now, what is GSTR-1? GSTR-1 is a return to be filed by all the registered person under GST. It is a return furnished for reporting the details of all the outward supply by such person. Now, having understood this, now let's move on to understand what is Form GSTR-2A. On the basis of data uploaded by the input supplier in Form GSTR-1, Form GSTR-2 is auto-generated for the recipient. For the recipient, data of GSTR-2 is auto-populated based on the GSTR-1 uploaded by all the input supplier of the supplies for the tax period. GSTR-2A is a read-only return and no action can be taken. It is auto-generated on the basis of GSTR-1. Having understood these two forms, let's move on to understand the restrictions imposed under Rule 36.4. After the insertion of this rule, one cannot take ITC without examining the credit available in Form GSTR-2A. Under Rule 36.4, ITC pertaining to input invoices, debit notes, which is available to the registered dealer for the tax period, cannot exceed 110% of eligible credit available in his form GSTR-2A. it is restricted to 110% of the ITC, that is eligible ITC available in GSTR 2A. Thank you, friends. So I kindly request you to subscribe to this channel and also like and share this video. Thank you for watching.